So many of you have been asking, can they opt for computer science engineering if they have bio in their plus one and plus two? In this video, I'm going to take you to the syllabus of mathematics that engineering has and guide you on how you can perform better in your computer science engineering. Coming up. Alright, so let's get into the video. So congratulations, you've passed your plus two and it's time to get into your college. And if you're watching this video, more specifically, you've opted for computer science engineering. But do not afraid if you have bio in your plus one and plus two and now you think you won't be able to perform well in your graduation. To give you an idea, engineering has more than 40 theory subjects and almost 15 to 20 practicals. Out of all these, only first year or till maybe first, second or third semester are the semester that are going to have mathematics. So in engineering, you have three mathematics, M1, M2 and M3. M1 is for first semester, M2 is for second semester and M3 is for third semester. So M1 and M2 are kindly considered to be a little tough, whereas M3 is quite easy. So if you have a basic knowledge of plus one and plus two physics and chemistry, and if you have done some of the differentiation, integration and all, it will not be tough for you to get into engineering. Now, if you move to first year, I have said in my other videos also that in first year, you're not at all straight away asked to get into computer science subjects. You'll read physics, chemistry, maths, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, some management subjects, some economic subjects, and one programming subject that might be C language. Then when you move to the second semester, again you're going to have physics, then maths, then your maybe mechanical or civil engineering, one subject from each of the fields so that you get an idea about all the engineering fields. But after you move into third semester, you're again going to have mathematics, but now you will start getting your more of computer science subjects. So it's not at all going to be that tough for you. Now, if you have a basic knowledge of maths, that I said integration or differentiation, it is going to be easy for you. Now, when you move to the first semester, I'm just giving you a brief idea on what will be the syllabus of maths. You're going to study infinite series. You're going to study matrix and its application. You're going to study differential calculus and integral calculus. Now, if you study the infinite series, that is the first part of your M1, that is mathematics one, you're going to study tests like Gaussian test, Rabe's test, Cauchy roots, and in matrix you're going to study Hamilton theorem and inversing a matrix, normalization of a matrix. So if you have a decent knowledge of all this in your plus one and plus two through physics, I think you will be able to do it. Also, always remember that the teachers who teach you in your engineering do not actually expect you to go and give you a question, you can solve it. All the these theorems and the rules that you will be learning in your engineering, teacher will be first giving the entire derivation of that theorem. Just the way you used to derive the theorems for your plus one and plus two in physics, in the same way, when you move into mathematics engineering, the teacher will first derive the entire theorem and then you will start learning all that. So everyone will be at same level. The only difference that you will find, if you will find from maths student and in yours, is that they kind of connect with them. They can, if a teacher is teaching a matrix, they can connect with it. Whereas it is not at all that tough so that you cannot match it. I mean, it's a matrix. If you know the multiplication of a matrix, if you know transposition of a matrix, if you know how to normalize it, in any case, when they go for a little advanced matrix, it is new for everyone. In most of the cases, all the things that they teach, it is new to everyone, no matter if you had maths in plus one and plus two or you had bio. So it is going to be very, very same. Now, when you move into mathematics two, you have subjects like vector calculus, that uses Stokes theorem or Gaussian theorems. Then you have section B as ordinal differential equations and applications, which actually has Newton laws of cooling. Then you move into Laplace transform and application, which is very, very important topic. and then partial differentiation equation and its application. Now when you move into M2, it gets a lot more like mathematics, like partial differentiation and equation. But if you remember, you also had this partial differentiation in physics in your plus 1 and plus 2 in many of your derivations, right? So it is not going to be that tough for you. Now once you have completed mathematics in first semester, you have also studied mathematics in second semester. Now when you move into third semester, it is going to be very easy for you. I mean, you're not going to face any tough because you have studied mathematics for 1 year and that too at a very good level. Now when you move into the third semester, you're going to have Fourier series, Fourier transform and statistics and all that. So third semester is not going to be tough for you. Just make sure that whenever a teacher teaches in the classroom, write down, okay, whatever he or she is teaching, go back home, do the derivation once again. And almost all the engineering colleges in India have the same syllabus. I believe 70 to 75% of the syllabus is very, very same. I have many of my friends studying in IIT and NIT, like NIT Roorkee, NIT Kurukshetra. So they also have the same syllabus. So do not worry that you come from a so-and-so college or a so-and-so college. Engineering is very easy in India. Okay, you can, if you study a day before, you can crack it with a decent scores. Not to promote it, don't do that. Okay, just I'm telling you, it's not that tough as you feel. So go ahead, if you have joined computer science engineering, all the best. And if you're willing to go and join, don't stop yourself. If you are passionate about computer science engineering, if you think you can program and build some very good applications, then go for it. I have many friends. Shout out to Nupur if you're watching this video. She was one of my friends and she did really well in engineering. And if you go to your college, you'll find not only you, but many students have come from bio field and they have opted for computer science engineering and they do really, really well. Believe me, during engineering, no one is very serious for their studies. So if you focus a little more, I believe you will be ahead than all others. Just remember one thing, that being very good at academics does not make sure that you will succeed after 4 years of graduation. I know many of my friends personally who have scored top at university level, but they still find it tough to get a good job because those subjects and knowledge are totally fine, but the companies look for more like a practical knowledge, and practical knowledge more being like not just even practical, on how expressive you are, on your personality, because engineering is a professional degree course where people expect you to face the clients. That is why you need to be a little smart and confident about your personality. Make sure you remember this. That's all from my side in this video. Thank you so much for watching till here. I upload videos on every Monday, Wednesday and Friday. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel so that whenever I upload a video, you get a notification. But for notification, you need to press that bell icon also. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Steven Simon. See you in the next video.